our most basic common link is that we all inhabit this small planet. We all breathe the same air. We all cherish our children's future.
En posant leur candidature pour le marché commun,
successful and prosperous future.
One day,
this nation will rise up.
Let me have a go on it. Look up destination setting. Right. D.S. TARDIS flight data, program journey. Destination hydrogen inrush, event one.
What are you getting at?
Well, think about what we've learned. Terminus seems to be at the center of the universe, yes? Now, imagine this ship in flight. Suddenly, the pilot finds he has an enormous amount of unstable fuel on board. What would you do?
Jettison it.
Perfectly normal procedure, unfortunately. He ejects his fuel into a void.
And it exploded.
Starting a chain reaction.
How big?
Enormous.
Hydrogen. Abundant element. Highly explosive in the presence of oxygen. Believed to be the basic constituent out of which the galaxy was first.
Biggest explosion of all time.
The creation of the galaxy out of a huge inrush of hydrogen.
Event one.
The Big Bang?
Yes.
We're heading straight into the biggest explosion in history.
Impossible.
Well, chemical reaction in a primeval swamp can create life on a planet. Why couldn't the universe be created by a similar chance factor, hmm?
Donna Noble, welcome to the creation of the Earth.
We've gone back 4.6 billion years. There's no solar system, not yet. Dust and rocks and gas.
That's the sun. Over there.
Brand new.
Just beginning to burn.
Where's the Earth?
All around us. In the dust.
So I came out of all this.
Isn't that brilliant?
Oh, I think that's the Isle of Wight.
Eventually, gravity takes hold. Say, one big rock, heavier than the other, starts to pull other rocks towards it. All the dust and gas and elements get pulled and everything, piling in until you get
to the Earth.
But the question is, what was that first rock?
Look.
Arachnos.
Arachnos are hiding from the war. What's it doing?
Exactly what you said.
Oh, they didn't just bury something in the center of the Earth. They became the center of the Earth. First rock.
What was that?
Trouble.
About 6 billion years ago, it's a Tuesday, I think.
Mention that wretched planet to me.
If you don't like it, then bog off.
I once spent centuries faithfully cataloging all the species there, every organism from the smallest bacteria to the largest ichthyosaur. And no sooner had I finished than it all started changing.
That's life.
What's that?
Some kind of a ball. It's got some markings on it. Have a look.
It's a globe. Surely that's the shape of the west coast of America. Where the landmass is all bunched together.
What's that? Let me have a look at that. Of course. This is the world as it was before the great continental drift. 200 million years ago.
Just where you thought we were, Captain.
Heathrow.
Some 140 million years ago.
I think I'm dreaming.
Definitely Jurassic. There's a nip in the air, though. We can't be far off the Pleistocene era.
The Ice Age?
It's times like this I wish I still had my scarf. Better watch out for the odd brontosaurus.
Dinosaurs.
An amazing species.
Are they your ancestors?
Well, I hope not.
Well, you should be proud if they were.
Oh, thank you very much. Most of them had a brain the size of a pea.
They were also the most successful creature ever to inhabit the Earth.
In what way?
Fossilized remains have been found all over the planet. Not bad adaptation for a creature with a brain the size of a pea.
How long did they exist?
100 million years or so. They seemed so secure, and yet they died out virtually overnight.
Such a successful species die out so quickly?
Initially hypothermia, then starvation.
Caused by what? An ice age?
Something equally as devastating. The Earth collided with something from space.
An asteroid?
Could be. I don't know. I've always meant to slip back and find out.
Excellent.
They've incorporated a machine of their own.
I suspect the ship is now on a locked-off fixed coordinate.
Are we still going to Earth?
Yes.
Well, then why lock off the coordinates?
Because I think they're turning us into a flying bomb.
We're travelling backwards in time.
That's not possible!
It is when you have an alien machine overriding your computer.
It may be of some small consequence to know we've travelled backwards in time some 65 million years.
Big deal.
Think about it.
Do you recall the fossil dinosaur bones in the cave on Earth?
What?
And why it's believed they died out so quickly?
Earth collided with a meteorite.
Or something. The freighter?
The antimatter vessel will split open on impact. There will be a tremendous explosion.
The
freighter was the meteorite?
It seems inevitable, as is your history as we know it. The Earth is safe.
Look!
Thank you,
Nimrod, sir.
Nimrod. Thank you, Nimrod. We would be, delighted.
If I might explain, sir.
Nimrod, yes. There's still some tea in the pot, if you'd like to go and get a couple of cups. Thank you very much.
The fang of a cave bear. A totem of great power.
Yes. Thank you, Nimrod.
I can understand that part of it, all right. But can't you explain the wider issues, Doctor?
Yes, all right. Now, creatures like those have been seen over and over again throughout the history of man. And man has turned them into myths. Gods or devils, but they're neither. They are, in fact, creatures from another world. They're daemons from the planet Deimos, which is
60,000 light years away on the other side of the galaxy.
And they first came to Earth nearly 100,000 years ago.
Well, I still don't get it. I mean, what's the creature doing here? I mean, why did they ever come?
To help Homo sapiens kick out Neanderthal man. They've been coming and going ever since. Oh, the Greek civilization, the Renaissance, the Industrial Revolution, they were all inspired by the daemons.
I think this is what you want, Mr. Chesterton. Here are some leaves and some dead grass.
Yes, well, good. Spread them around the hole. Don't put them inside. Yeah. I think this is going to work. No, spread them around a bit more. Yes, that's it.
What is this? We are making fire. For you.
I am watching. Look, I think it's beginning to work. Susan, Barbara, blow gently.
It's... You've done it.
Yes.
Is dead. I give you fire. I am leader.
Wake up.
What do you know of history, sir? What do you know of next year?
You're not making sense,
Barry. 1914, sir. Because the family has traveled far and wide looking for Mr. Smith and all the things we have seen. War is coming. In foreign fields, war of the whole wide world with all your boys falling down in the mud.
Yes, I'm afraid we've landed right in the middle of one of the worst wars in human history.
In June 1914, an Archduke of Austria was shot by a Serbian. And this then led through nations having treaties with nations, like a line of dominoes falling.
Well, I believe they call it the war to end wars.
War is hell, eh?
Das ist verrückt. Ich will den nicht wie tun.
Is that Christmas carols?
Silent night, holy night.
You know, I could swear it's coming from both sides.
Any other day it wouldn't make any difference, but this is Christmas 1914. And the human miracle is about to happen. The Christmas armistice.
Wounded man here! Wounded man!
Never happened again. Any war, anywhere.
Is this madness? Am I going mad?
Madness?
Well, you're an officer from World War I at the South Pole.
Madness was never this good.
World War I?
Judging by the uniform, yes.
Yes, but what do you mean, one?
...1941. Right now, not very far from here, the German war machine is rolling up the map of Europe. Country after country falling like dominoes. Nothing can stop it. Nothing. Until one tiny, damp little island says, no! No. Not here. A mouse in front of a lion. Don't know what you do to Hitler. You frighten the hell out of me. Off you go, then. Do what you've got to do. Save the world.
They have no power, no labor in the daytime. They sleep beyond England's foe. They went with songs to the battle. They were young, straight of limb, true of eye, steady and aglow. They were staunch to the end against odds uncounted. They fell with their faces to the foe. They shall not grow old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
but this falling with my man.
I'm gonna need those seats back there. Y'all better make it light on yourselves and let me have those seats.
I should have to.
If you don't stand, I'm gonna have you arrested.
You may do that.
On Monday, the boycotts begin. Across Montgomery, people refuse to use the buses as a response to Rosa's arrest. And in just over a year, on the 21st of December 1956, segregation on buses in Montgomery was ended. But she changed the world. In fact, she changed the universe. Look at this. Asteroid 284996, also known as Rosa Parks.
Barbara, we made it!
Leave it.
London, 1965.
Gotta go. Got company.
Don't worry, I've got everything back the way I found it. Except this. There's always a bit left over, isn't there? Then why did the human race suddenly decide to go to the moon?
9. Ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4.
Because the silence needed a space.
1, 0, all engines on. Liftoff, we have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour. Liftoff.
Well, Armstrong and Aldrin making their descent to the surface of the moon.
And every single one of them at some point in their lives will look back at this man taking that very first step, and they will never, ever forget it.
Okay, engine stop. Power control, we'll follow the engine command.
But they'll forget this bit.
It's one small step for man.
You should get us all on sight! You should get us all on sight!
You've given the order for your own execution, and the whole planet just heard you.
One giant leap for mankind.
And one whacking great kick up the backside for the silence.
I am the boss. I'm all around you. Exactly. I am the computer.
Do you like it?
Do I like it? I love it. Is it really a prime computer?
Do you know about them?
Know about them? I've seen them on Gallifrey in the constellation of Cerberus. Ha ha! At last, I'm up to date. Okay, Prime. How long's my scarf?
Well, it's not that impressive.
What? In 7 computer languages and 5 protocols.
Protocols?
Yes. That's how it talks to other computers.
It talks to other computers?
Well, of course it does. It's a prime. You're going to be all right, kid.
Genuine. Zero bubble. Zero. 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 Zero.
prepare to launch nuclear weapons.
Aye, sir.
Firebird stands ready to serve.
For the motherland.
For the motherland.
This means nothing to me. This means nothing to me. Oh, Vienna.
Have I interrupted something?
We were about to blow up the world, Professor.
Again.
Very dangerous time, Clara. East and West standing on the brink of nuclear oblivion. Lots of itchy fingers on the button.
Isn't it always like that?
Sort of, but there are flashpoints, and this is one of them.
Hair,
shoulder pads, nukes. It's the 80s. Everything's bigger.
Both sides are capable of completely obliterating the other. It's a state we call mutually assured destruction.
Mutually assured destruction.
What if they fired one by accident? What would happen then?
Well, I told you, Clara, Earth is like a storm waiting to break right now. Both sides baring their teeth, talking up war. It would only take one tiny spark.
Yeah, but the world didn't end in 1983, did it? Or I wouldn't be here.
You.
About 12 hours. Do you know, like we were saying about the Earth revolving? It's like when you're a kid. The first time they tell you that the world's turning and you just can't quite believe it because everything looks like it's standing still. I can feel it. The turn of the Earth. The ground beneath our feet is spinning at 1,000 miles an hour, and the entire planet is hurtling round the sun at 67,000 miles an hour, and I can feel it. We're falling through space, you and me, clinging to the skin of this tiny little world, and if we let go... That's who I am. Yeah.
I want chips.
Me too.
Right then, before you get me back in that box, chips it is, and you can pay.
No money.
What sort of date are you? Come on then, tightwad, chips are on me. I've only got 5 billion years till the shops close.